Hello and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new here, my name is Georgia. So today I'm doing another reaction to Al Bundy, just because like I really enjoyed the last one, so I thought I would do it again. So yeah, I found one called Al Bundy, How Was Your Day? So I'm gonna react to that. So yeah, let's get on with the video.
Whoa, Bundy!
A fat woman clip-clopped into the shoe store today. And said, I need something I'd be comfortable in. I said, try Wyoming. Now, I don't know when they started letting women carry chainsaws. You know that new aerobic center up above me? The one with the sign, quarter ton discount? Well, today they played Van Halen's Jump. And damned if the whole herd didn't. It was awful, Peg. The ceiling opened up, down they came, blocking out the sun. I experienced cellulite winter. God, the humongity. A fat woman Godzilla's into the shoe store today. Asked for something she could wear to walk in the woods. Jokingly, I suggest she wear a sign that says, don't shoot from the front, I look human. Middle-aged woman comes into the shoe store. She's wearing a blossom hat. You know, the I'm just a cute young girl of 45 look. And she's looking for something cool to wear to a Crosby, Stills, and Nash reunion concert. So I suggest a nice recyclable paper bag to put over her face. You know, so she can save the planet two ways. So she maces me. But as I lash out blindly, I think I clipped her a good one in the teeth. So from now on, it looks like she'll be gumming the words to teach your children. How was your day, pumpkin?
Do you know what? Can I just say, the insults in this show are so brilliantly like thought up. They're so creative, so much so that maybe, you know, in future, when someone like tries to insult me or anything, I'll take some of these insults, commit them to my memory, and use them on people who try to be rude to me. Because do you know what? And I feel like people my age, or like around my age, probably won't know about this show. So they won't know that's where I've got it from, so I could pretend that I thought of these insults just because they're so creative. Do you know what I mean? I would look so creative, but yeah. I just wanted to say that. That is pretty good.
Words to teach your children. How was your day, pumpkin?
A customer comes in the store today. Tall, willowy brunette. Sits down. Says she'd like to try on a pair of size 12 pumps. So I'm down there, you know, just doing my job, and notice she's wearing a garter belt like I like. And a nice pair of silk stockings. All the time she's smiling at me, all of a sudden, she uncrosses her legs like in Basic Instinct.
You saw it all?
Yes.
It was a guy!
Oh, Peg, it was horrible. 16 straight hours of shoe-selling mayhem. Last thing I remember, I was down on one knee, waiting on an overflowing glacier of a woman. First thing they teach you when you're a rookie shoe salesman is when you got a fat one in the chair, never look up. I looked up, Peg. I saw underwear. It said Saturday.
So what?
Today's Wednesday.
Can I just say, is her hairstyle like a hairstyle from the past? Because her hair is huge. Like, were people, like women back in the day, or how, like whenever this show was made, walk around with like huge hair like that? Oh, I've just noticed how like big her hair is.
So what?
Today's Wednesday. Anyway, the next thing I knew, I was insane.
A customer comes into the diner, and he asks for the Norwegian salmon. Then he wants to know if it's fresh. I said, hey, Chucklehead, this is Chicago. This is not Norwegia, okay? Nothing is fresh. Well, I shouldn't say nothing.
I hate Christmas. Mall is full of nothing but women and children. All you hear is, I want this, get me this, I have to have this. And there's the children. And they're all by my store because they stuck the mall Santa right outside ringing his stupid bell. As if you need a bell to notice a 300-pound alcoholic in a red suit. Ho, 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 all day long. So nice as can be, I go outside, ask him to shut the hell up. He takes a swing at me. So I lay a hook into his fat belly and he goes down. Beard comes off, all the kids start crying, and I'm the bad guy.
This woman comes in, and she...
Do you know what? I love little clever jokes like that, like blindside you. Because, like, you know, like, the bit in the beginning where, like, you think he's talking about that, but he's really talking about this, and, like, blindside you, and it's really funny. Probably didn't know what I'm talking about, but, yeah, I just love, like, a clever joke. And this show is clearly just filled with, like, clever insults and clever jokes. But, yeah.
Comes off, all the kids start crying, and I'm the bad guy.
This woman comes in, and she is so fat, she actually has three smaller women orbiting around her. So I'm trying to force a pair of size 13 shoes on her Jurassic feet, when she says to me that her husband just left her.
Ah, the plot thins.
And the skinny woman with a hooked nose olive oils into the shoe store and says, I want something to make me look sexy. So I say, you'll have to wait a long time before someone that ugly comes in to stand next to you. Excuse me, boy. Now, I don't know when they started letting women carry nunchucks. A fat woman hedgehogged her way into the shoe store today.
I got to tell you about my day. I had to give a driving test to a woman who was so fat, they had to shoot her driver's license photo with the Hubble telescope.
Son, listen to me. I don't have time for one of your shaggy fat woman stories. Oh, how I hate Halloween. Ask me how much I hate Halloween. More than that. Oh, they make all us employees put on these costumes like some woman's gonna say, gee, I wasn't gonna buy any shoes today. But since I see you in a dinosaur costume, I will. And of course, the ride home from work wouldn't have been so bad if the kids had actually got gas instead of painting the needle on the gauge full. But then again, I don't mind pushing the Dodge through gang turf because I'm a mighty stegosaurus. By the way, did I mention how much I hate Halloween?
Go away.
Do you know what? Sometimes you really can't do that, can't you? Like when you're annoyed about something little, and your dog's just sat there, you'll just talk to your dog. Because it's not like people who respond to you and be like, oh, you know what? Like, that's really such a tiny issue that you're complaining about. Like, you know, you could just speak to your dog who won't respond to you and can't tell that what you're saying is, you know, stupid and pathetic and your problems aren't that big. But yeah.
How much I hate Halloween.
Go away.
Ah, home sweet help. So then, this woman comes in, who doesn't speak English. She points at the shoes, I point at the door. She points at the sky, and knees me in the nay-nays.
Woman comes to the gate.
That is literally, sorry to pause again, but that is literally like the definition of like, you know, when you're telling a story that you've told a billion times, like, or like when someone else, like for example, like your dad, like this is showing, is telling a story that you've heard like so many times, you know, about work or about something, you know, so you're kind of just sat there like zoning out and you kind of just pop in every now and then and go, okay, sure, and then pop out again. You're just like, oh, okay. But yeah, see, that's what I like about this show especially, is like, it's just showing like, yes, obviously it's like an overdramatic comedic version, so it's not going to be like completely realistic to the normal family, but in a way it kind of does show like just like the normal family life and kind of what it's like, and it makes it more fun to watch and like interesting, just like, you know, and kind of like original. I don't really know what I'm trying to get at here, but like, you know what I mean, just like the show, it has like a nice just chill, like, you know, like you're just watching a family kind of show. Because sometimes when you watch a show, it's like you can tell that like it's just actors acting. I like how natural their acting is, so it actually makes it feel like you're watching a dad complaining or just like a family, you know. Not gonna ramble on anymore, but yeah.
and knees me in the nay-nays.
A fat woman comes to the gate today. Her moo-moo covering what must have been 3 or 4 hymies. Now, she could exit through a little itsy-bitsy turnstile or a huge gate. Guess which one she chooses. A line was forming. So I had to do something. So I got a tub of butter from the Delta Burke Let's Get Big exhibit. And oiled her up. Then I went over to Star Trek land, hotwired the Enterprise, and sent it up where no man has gone before.
If that's his daughter in the show, then that is like the definition of like, or like the saying, like father, like daughter. Do you know what I mean? Like they both come in and someone says, how was your day? And then this is, and then they go into a story about like something. Like father, like daughter.
Sent it up where no man has gone before. She goes flying like a vegetable out of dad's mouth. Right into the Facts of Life fan club pavilion. Thank God it's always empty.
A woman comes in the shoe store today, so huge she's protected by Greenpeace, and asks for a size 4 shoe. So, I ask her if she wants to eat them there or take them home. And she has the nerve to complain about my performance.
A fat woman sloshed into the shoe store today, said she was retaining water. I said not to worry about it. The dam of cellulite holding it back should keep us all high and dry for the next few years. Now, I don't know when they started letting women carry stun guns. Why am I early on what used to be my bowling night? Good question. Thank you for asking. Well, as I entered the bowling alley, ready for an exciting night of bonding brewskis and barfing, what did I see? Women bowling. Overhand. So naturally, I went up to one of these donut depositories and said in my nicest voice, wedge it out the door, Beefalo, it's my night to bowl. Well, instead of coming back at me verbally like I did to them, they took their doughy fist and they pounded on me until a mutual agreement was reached that I leave. Anyway, when I regained consciousness in a burning trash can, I realized, A, Thursday nights is now ladies' night, and B, you don't want to know how a bum puts out a trash can fire. A fat woman creatured her way into the shoe store today.
Guess what happened today at the shoe store?
Did a fat woman come in?
Enormous.
So, yeah, I think that's the end of that video. Do you know what? I just love how, like, creative the insults are on the show. Just, like, to make them funny. And it's kind of clever at the same time as well. Like, clever and funny and just, like, a nice little watch. So, yeah, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe and please turn on the notification bell. Goodbye.